So as some of you may know, me and my friends are working on a game using NESmaker titled Nessie the NES Robot. Well, just recently, well, on Thanksgiving actually, the new 8-Bit Heroes, the team that made NESmaker, uploaded a video showing previews of the new things that are going to be added to NESmaker in 4.1.0. In this video, I'm going to be going over everything that I'm actually excited for when it comes to this new update. It's going to be quite a big update for the software, actually. The first big update is a new way for you to play sprites. Originally, you had to click on an area within the sprite size itself, then go to the sprite sheet and then click which sprite you want, then you had to click again, then click again, and things like that. Well, now, all you need to do is click on the top leftmost area that you want the sprite to be in, hold shift, and then drag over the sprites that you want to be placed. And there you go. This is going to change sprite placement for a long time, because back then it was tedious to keep on continuously clicking. Now you just have this drag and drop feature, and it's amazing. And speaking of which, they also added a brand new flip animation button. So let's say you had a walking sprite. Now you wanted to make the character have a walking left sprite. Originally what you had to do is you had to go to one frame, then flip that, and then go to another frame, then flip that, and things like that. Well, now the new flip animation button flips every single frame that is in that section. Now, one thing that's pretty cool about NESmaker is that you can have certain tiles have certain objectives. You can have one be a checkpoint, you can have one be a monster block tile, so that way the monster doesn't go over the tile, and just it basically acts like a red Koopa Troopa from Super Mario Brothers. And you have the one-way platforms, much like in Super Mario Maker, you have trap doors, death tiles, and things like that. You can have those all in one screen. However, it was hard to know which one was which. Well, now they have a new tile collection button that shows which tile is which based on numbers. So let's say number 3 would be the one-way platforms, number 0 would be the air tiles, number 9 would be the one-way platforms, etc. This is going to make tile placement a lot more convenient. Another interesting thing that NESmaker added in 4.1.0 that is going to make rendering your games or playtesting your games a lot easier is now they have a direct export or export test button. Now that is amazing, because beforehand what we had to do was go to the test menu that was in NESmaker, then click export and test. They didn't have it directly in the menu, you had to go to a side menu and then export. But now they have a button that is directly on the menu to let you export and test your game. That is going to make things go by a lot faster now. And finally, the biggest update to NESmaker that I was hoping for a long time. They are now adding scrolling to the game. I'm so excited for this. Everybody is going to be excited for this. Originally, if you were making a side-scrolling game, they didn't have actual scrolling. There was no scrolling in NESmaker. And if I remember, it was due to the engine that they had at the time. Well, now they're finally adding scrolling to the game. One thing interesting that they showed is that you have to have two screens connected together in order for the scrolling to work, which, you know, makes sense. But that makes me think if we can manipulate that to our advantage by having a gap be between two certain screens, so that way it stops at one screen and then you teleport or go to another just like regular NESmaker, and then it continues scrolling, much like what Mega Man does, and Castlevania does, and Metroid does. Now, one thing that we don't know about NESmaker 4.1.0 is when it's going to be released, but according to the preview video itself, they said that it was going to be released very, very soon.
So that's a quick look at some of the amazing updates that we've been working on for 4.1.0, which will be coming so, so soon.
So I'm hoping sometime before Christmas, either this coming week or next week, but all I know it's going to be sometime before Christmas. But I want to hear what you think. What are your thoughts on this new update that's coming out to NESmaker? Do you like it or do you hate it? I personally like it, but I want to hear what you think. Tell me in the comments. And if you have any other suggestions for what you want me to talk about next, and if you have any fan that they want to submit to me, you can submit them on via Twitter, Discord, comment section below, or the community tab. And if you did enjoy this video, hit the like button, and if you're new, the subscribe button, and the notification bell to be notified whenever I upload a video. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.